Welcome back to L3 Television. I'm Erica Draper, and in just a few moments, we have a great guest coming on our show. Marcus Malone is a Memphis musician. He also has a school of music for children, and in just a few weeks, he has a great event coming up where he honors women in ministry. Stay tuned. Hello, I'm Erica Draper. Welcome to L3 Television. Today we have Marcus Malone as our special guest. Marcus, you want to say hello to the people?
Hey, how you doing?
All right, Marcus is a Memphis musician, and today we're going to get into a little bit about what he exactly does and his award show that's coming up. So, Marcus, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, I'm Marcus Malone. I'm from Cairoville, Tennessee, a small town right outside of Memphis. I've been playing since I was 5 years old. I started out playing drums for my home church, St. Mark Missionary Baptist Church. Started playing drums, started playing organ when I was 13. So started out playing nothing but bass lines. Like, I knew no chords or nothing. Just playing bass lines for the mill chords. So quartets is my roots. You know anything about quartet?
I don't, but I'm here. That's why you're here, for you to tell me and tell our guests.
Right. Quartet music is a great background for a musician, a great starting point for a musician. Kind of builds that foundation of being a great musician. And, you know, it's four singers, right? So quartet means four.
Okay.
All right, so normally it's a group of men, but you have some female quartet groups.
Okay.
But started out playing quartet, then my stepfather, Fred Banks, he's actually a musician himself, so he started showing me some chords. Started playing my first song, Jesus is the Light that shineth in me. My first song I ever learned how to play, I remember sitting at my mom's piano playing it. I used to scribble on some paper like I was reading music, and just I was sitting there playing Jesus is Light, wasn't reading nothing, but I was sitting there crying, and I didn't know like why I was crying, but it's like I knew then that I had a gift from God. And I started playing for this group called Pamela Armour in the Memphis Shop, and we're actually honoring her this year in Church Girls Rock. We'll talk about that a little later.
All right.
But started playing with her, did my first tour in Italy.
Wow.
Yeah, played in front of the Pope. It was a great experience. I was young, maybe like 18 years old in Italy. So after I stopped playing with Pam, started playing with Daryl Pettis.
Okay.
In Strength and Praise.
Yeah.
Which Daryl Pettis, he's my best friend, my right hand business partner, all the above. I started playing with him. I produced a couple of his records, At the Cross, New Season. So I'm still currently his music director.
Okay.
Or whatnot. Just let me know when to stop. I got a long music history. But
no, we want to hear this.
Okay,
this
okay.
is what it's for. Go ahead.
Okay, great.
We want to get to know you.
Right. So I did that, and I'm currently playing at Mississippi Boulevard Christian Church.
Okay.
Also, New Friendship Full Gospel Church. So I'm the music director there. Great church. So I get a lot of word. I get a lot of church in every Sunday. And also, the Lord blessed me to start my own school. It was a year, a couple of weeks ago.
All right.
So I've been in my school, Total Experience School of Music, 348 in New Bahia Road. That's in Cairoville, Suite 2. We're happy to offer piano lessons. I do piano lessons and drum lessons, organ lessons. We offer guitar lessons, bass lessons, vocal lessons. So anybody need any lessons, we giving back to the community. God has blessed me to go around the world and play music with a lot of different artists, and that's something that I want to do.
Yeah.
Give back to the community at affordable costs. Right. It's called School of Music, so you don't have to pay a tuition or nothing like that. We call it School of Music because we actually give homework assignments.
Okay.
And we actually teach you about the history of your instrument, not just how to play, but we want you to know where that instrument came from, who used to play that instrument, and things like that. So been open about a year now. God has blessed me with 42 students now.
Wow.
Yeah, 42 students. So that's a blessing. And this year, a couple of months ago, I got endorsed with Yamaha.
Okay.
Corporation of America. I got endorsed with Hammond Organ. And I got endorsed with 1964 Ears, which is an in-ear company that creates custom in-ear monitors for your ears. It's kind of hard to explain.
Yeah,
but
I guess.
Some of the musicians don't know what I'm talking about. But that was like a dream come true. My first keyboard was a Yamaha S80.
Okay.
And like my dad bought that for me, and I cherished it. It was a big, huge keyboard. We used to haul it in the car, and it was crazy that that I actually got endorsed with a company that I always dreamed of being endorsed with. And
I can only imagine.
Right. And so I'm a part of this project that's coming out. I can't really disclose what it is. But
So you're not going to give us a scoop?
I really can't right now. Marcus. But it's something huge, and it's like a tremendous blessing. But my music is not only going to be in the United States, is going to be global.
Wow. So can you give us, since you can't disclose any information, can you at least tell us when to be on the lookout for it?
January.
So be prepared. January 2016, Marcus Malone is going to make a big, huge announcement.
Right. So. It's going to be huge. So I had a big, huge endorsement party. A lot of the Memphis musicians came out. And that's really what I'm about in this season, helping upcoming musicians. Mm-hmm. I bring different musicians in town that like play for a lot of major artists, yeah, like Calvin Rogers, Tony Russell, and we do things like All About the Strings or Thankful for the Drummers. So just something, my way to give back to the musicians and to give people hope, give the musicians hope, give them something to dream about, because I feel like that's something that I lacked growing up as a musician. Wow. Yeah. I really didn't have a musical mentor. And I think that's so important for musicians to have a mentor, because really you need that. You need somebody pushing you. You need somebody telling you when you're doing wrong. You need somebody basically guiding you in the right way. And a lot of places I go around the world, a lot of people always say that Memphis has the best talent in the world musically. Mm-hmm. And that's true. We have a lot of talent here. But they say that our business ethics is poor.
Okay.
Or our business is not together. And I really want to do something about that. I really want to pull together a lot of the elite musicians and really to gather everybody, not just the musician, but the singers, everybody, and just basically educate everybody on business.
So do you sing as well? Do you have any other kind of performance skills?
Well,
I know you said we can learn them at your school, but what right. else do you do? Do you sing? Right. Do you dance? Or do you act? Or are you just the musician? Well, do you just play the instruments?
I can sing a number for you right now. I'm just playing.
Can you give us 5 seconds?
No, I don't proclaim to be a solo singer. I sing background, and okay, I love teaching choirs. I've done 4 musical workshops.
Okay, cool.
Where we actually train choirs. So no, I'm not a solo singer.
Do you have any of that coming up?
I don't got a workshop coming up now. I've been so busy with Church Girls okay. Rock and other visions.
We're gonna get into Church Girls yeah. Rock on the next segment.
Right, right. I got you.
So I think that'll be it. We'll be back to you in a second after the break.
L3 Media is the Mid-South's premier videography and photography company. We specialize in capturing all of life's greatest moments. Whenever you need talented and professional service for your special events or business, L3 Media is the company for you. You can contact us at all of our social media sites. You can like us on Facebook. Check out our website. Follow us on Twitter. Or always feel free to email us. We are L3 Media, your number one source for all your videography and photography needs. Give us a call today.
Every part of me is a vision of a portrait of Mona. Mona Lisa. Part of me is beautiful, and I finally see I'm a work of art, a masterpiece. Who is this I tried so long to find, filling my head with lies that I'm not good enough? Then I heard something in my ear tell me I'm perfect. Now that I know the truth, time to show and prove. Every part of me is a vision of a portrait of Mona, a Mona Lisa. Every part of me is beautiful, and I finally see I'm a work of art, a masterpiece.
Whoa. 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 Again. again. I'm Erica Draper. Welcome back to L3 Television. And we're back with Marcus Malone. Marcus, can you give us a little bit or a rundown of what your upcoming event, Church Girls Rock, is?
Church Girls Rock. This is the third annual Church Girls Rock. It was a vision that God gave to me when I was at my former church, Greater Works, Deliverance Ministries. A lady came to me and said, Marcus, do you have anything that we could do for Women's Month? And so I'm a visionary. Like, I have a lot of crazy vision. So I was like, yeah, let's do something called Church Girls Rock or whatnot. And really, I didn't know all that was going to come behind it, but it sounded cool.
Yeah.
So as I started praying about it, God started giving me different ideas. And just basically, it's a way to honor women of faith, honor women that's in the church that play important roles, like the mothers of the church, the ushers of the church, the first ladies, the PKs, the missionaries, the evangelists, all the women. So it's something to basically give back. And by me being a musical guy, I wanted to incorporate an all-girls choir.
Wow.
And an all-girls band. So I think we made Memphis history by the first organization that actually offer all women's choir and all women's band at the same time. But this year is going to be phenomenal. We got some great categories. We're already in the voting process.
Okay, tell us a little bit about what categories can we expect, or what do you have
for? Right, all of our categories are named after flowers, and I don't want to get into the names of the flowers because I may forget some of them. But
just give us maybe two or three.
Like the Torch Award, I think that's like the first lady category. Okay. Then we got the Camellia Flower, that's the PK category.
Okay.
Then we got the favorite evangelist, the favorite choir director and / minister music.
Okay.
Favorite usher, favorite psalmist, which is a singer. And we got favorite, and we're doing like a music legend award to Pam Armour. I spoke about her in my other segment. We're doing like she's actually one of the first African-American women out of Memphis that had our own choir that actually recorded nationally. So that's huge to me, and I don't think that it's been properly recognized and celebrated. So I'm excited about that. Also, we're honoring, we got a Lifetime Achievement Award. This lady, she's 99 years old.
Wow.
And she's going to be at Church Girls Rock. And we're also honoring breast cancer survivors. We don't just honor the women of the church. Yeah, we actually donate a lot of our proceeds to the Wings Foundation, which is a cancer foundation that they don't just assist the families with breast cancer, but the families that with people that's dealing with all kinds of cancer. So,
yeah.
All right, so we're giving back to them. It's November the 7th at Oak Grove on Highway 64. It starts at 6 p.m. We got a lot of great performances. You don't want to miss it. This is my first year including the all-girls children's choir.
Yeah.
Very excited about that.
So what age group are the children?
Oh, the children's choir is 5 to 15.
Wow.
And those babies are singing. Like, they're incredible. Like, it touched my heart last night at rehearsal, like, to see them lifting their hands and worshiping God and so excited about song. We're doing some original songs. Me and my stepfather wrote a song for the event that really is going to be great.
Okay, so can you tell us maybe who's sponsoring the event, or do you sponsor it? How do you get the funds, or how does that work?
All right, well, last year we had a lot of good sponsors like Cigna, Healthcare and Methodist, and the Red Wing Group. This year, we don't have a presenting sponsor.
Okay.
So Total Experience, which is a production company that I have a team, great group of individuals. So it's Total Experience presents Church Girls Rock. But we have like some smaller sponsors, but they're still important, like MJ Edwards Funeral Home. I've been playing for MJ Edwards Funeral Home for 11 years.
Really?
Yeah, I'm the chapel musician.
Wow.
So they're sponsoring. Also, the Gibson Mechanical, the lady I know that, and her husband has their own business. They was some sponsors as well. So,
okay. So tell us about a little bit of the behind the scenes work. What actually goes into making this entire award show come together? The decorations, the venue. Do you do all of that, or do you have someone to work with you? How does all of that work?
Right. That's the hard part. It's a lot on one person. But my team, they're pretty good. I got a guy named Anthony James. He's kind of assists me with the production part of it. So he helps out a lot. One of my best friends, Buffy Williams, she's like our caterer. My other best friend, Alicia Miller, she's like been my right hand in this project. Also, I have another young lady helping me with the pre-show, Vita Reese, Beyond Reality. She got a new company, new business, coordinating. So be on the lookout for that, because she's really phenomenal at what she does. But my whole team really make it happen. I don't want to name everybody. Rakiria, Christy, Jeremy, Terrell.
Just going to give everybody a shout out.
Danielle. Shouting everybody out because they work hard.
Okay.
And I appreciate that.
So you have a good strong.
LaShondra. I didn't forget you.
Solid foundation behind you.
Right,
that's
right.
Good. Well, tell us one more time when we can exactly expect for the event to happen and where the people should go so they're on the lookout for it.
All right, you can visit our website at www.churchgirlswithasrockmemphis.com. Go on there, you can purchase your tickets. It's $10 pre-sale, $15 at the door. Now, Memphis is a slow city with buying pre-sale tickets, but I'm telling you, this is going to be a sold-out event. We have some phenomenal women, so go get your tickets. You can get your t-shirts, black and pink or white and pink, or you can just go there for updates. Be there early. Doors open at 5:30. Okay, we're starting at 6 on time. All right?
On time.
On time.
All right, we'll be right back to you guys after the break.
L3 Media is the Mid-South premier videography and photography company. We specialize in capturing all of life's greatest moments. Whenever you need talented and professional service for your special events or business, L3 Media is the company for you. You can contact us at all of our social media sites. You can like us on Facebook. Check out our website. Follow us on Twitter. Or always feel free to email us. We are L3 Media, your number one source for all your videography and photography needs. Give us a call today.
Every part of me is a vision of a portrait of Mona, Mona Lisa. Every part of me is beautiful, and I finally see I'm a work of art, a masterpiece. So long to find, filling my head with lies that I'm not good enough. Then I heard something in my ear tell me I'm perfect. Now that I know the truth, time to show and prove. Every part of me is a vision of a portrait of Mona, Mona Lisa. Finally see I'm a work of art, a masterpiece.
We're back to L3 Television with Marcus Malone. So Marcus, if you could play with anyone or for anyone, who would it be and why?
That's a tough question. I would love to. It's my dream to play with Stevie Wonder.
How did I know you were going to say it?
I don't know why.
How did I know you were going to say it?
Stevie Wonder is like my all-time favorite. I know all of his songs. I know what key they're in. So if I ever got that call, I would be so ready to do that gig. But I'm actually the youngest musician to ever play with Cameo.
Okay.
You know the group that sing Word Up?
I know.
And Just Like Candy and Sparkle and Alligator yeah. Woman. So that playing with Cameo alone has opened up a lot of doors for me, and especially like getting those endorsements and things. So, but it had to be Stevie Wonder.
So yeah. I take it Stevie is your favorite musician.
Well, he's not my favorite musician.
Okay, well then tell us who he is.
He's one of my favorites. One of my favorite musicians, I would say, is Corey Henry.
Okay.
But my favorite, I would say, in the city musician would probably be one of my great friends, Tim Mason.
Okay. Tell us why. How do they inspire you? What motivation do they give you?
Right. Tim Mason, well, he basically showed me a lot about being a professional musician. When I started playing with Daryl, he was still Daryl's music director. So he left and started playing with Kurt Carr. So.
Okay.
Delvis, I was like next in line for the big position. I'm like, man, I can't feel these shoes. Like, he's a monster. But he's actually showed me a lot. It's more to just playing when you talk about being a professional musician. It's a lot of knowing the business. I tell people all the time, it's like 10% is your talent, 90% is your business ethics.
Being the business.
So I really want to shout him out for being that mentor to me and just showing me the loops and showing me the ropes.
Okay. So is there any instrument that you ever tried to learn how to play that you couldn't master? Or are you just perfect and you have them all?
No, I don't have them all. I wish I did. But I would love to be a bass player.
You would love? Okay. Yeah,
I said if I knew how to play bass, I probably wouldn't play keyboard.
Okay.
But when I play key bass, like if I play one keyboard at the bottom, keyboard at the top, but my mind is like trained like a bass player because I want to be a bass player so much. I got a friend named Jonathan Rayburn, one of my favorite bass players. He's so funky. He's a funky bass player. But I try to mimic stuff that he does and a lot of other bass players. So I would love to be a bass player.
So is that something that you're working towards or is that a goal for you?
And it's sad that I'm not I'm surrounded. I got so many musician friends. It's sad that we all don't know how to play everybody's instrument because we around each other all the time. But
well, you got to give a group a good foundation. I get there like somebody can do everything.
Yeah, when I get ready to retire, like when I have a whole lot of time on my hands, I'll probably learn how to play bass.
I understand that. So tell me, if you weren't into music or if you weren't a musician, what would be your dream job or what would you want to do?
My dream if I wasn't a musician? Well, it's crazy because I don't think like a musician.
Yeah.
In my mind, I feel like I'm an entrepreneur that just so happened to know how to play.
Oh, so fancy.
Right. I have a lot of visions to start my own restaurant. I got some other great visions that's coming up next year.
Tell us about them.
That I'm going to do. Well, I'm going to do a live record next year with children. And it's called Dream Kids.
Okay.
So this is a good way to copyright it. So it's going to be called Dream Kids. And we're going to do this big We Are the World type choir. I want all ethnic backgrounds, not just African Americans, I want everybody a part of this choir. And we're going to record at the FedEx Forum speaking it. All right. I'm a man of faith. I'm a man of faith. Like
you heard this on L3 television first about Marcus
Malone.
Right. This
is the first time I ever told. Right. Dream Kids. I am the dream. Yeah, so I want to do this big march, like a children's march.
Okay.
March down Main Street or Beale Street.
Wow.
Wait, it's going to be crazy. Watch.
Well, make sure you contact us so we can be there first. And we have it on L3 television.
Most definitely.
So since you brought up food and you may have wanted to start a restaurant if you weren't into music, what is your favorite food or what are your favorite places to eat?
Oh, man. My favorite food is lasagna. And homemade tacos.
And what else?
I love cheese. I don't think it's nobody in Memphis loves cheese more than me. I love cheese, but I'm actually going to start it's like a dessert restaurant.
Okay.
It's going to have like exclusive desserts and it's going to be designed for couples.
Okay.
Because I feel like when dating, we don't have a lot of places to go where we can just be intimate with one another and feel like we're on a date.
Yeah.
So I want to have this place like when you get through with your dinner and all of that, you can come to this place to close it out and just have that one-on-one session. Be the perfect place to propose, perfect place to like rekindle stuff. And we're just going to have nothing but love music, slow dancing, you know.
Are you going to play or are you going to have a band to play?
I'm not going to play.
So you're not going to give us any kind of music. You indeed should have brought your
keyboard.
But
we're going to have a band.
Okay, so we do get some.
Yep, live couple karaoke.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So I guess this isn't my last question. I was going to say it's my last question.
Okay.
But it's not. So what is your ultimate goal or your life goal when you're done with Church Girls Rock, Dream Kids, and everything so after that? Mm-hmm. What is your ultimate goal to say you've completely lived life and done everything that you've wanted to do?
My ultimate goal is to basically be a mogul to my city. Like I want people to remember me as that musician that was different. He had a lot going for himself, but he was different. He was still touchable.
Mm-hmm.
Like he reached back and brought us to where he is. Like I want people to remember me as that positive light and just that person to remind people that you can do whatever you want to do if you put your mind to it. Like don't let nobody discourage you. Don't let your friends bring you down. Like people that you thought was for you and they turn their back on you when success comes. Don't worry about that. I want to be that person to say, I went hard for my city. A lot of people leave Memphis and go make it, which is fine, but it seems like people when they make it, they forget to come back. And grab the musicians and grab the younger people. But I'm going to be that person to prove to people that you can make it being in Memphis.
Yeah.
I'm not saying I'm be here forever, but when I leave, I'm going to be successful, right?
That's the mark that I want to leave on the city, and that's a very good mark. All right, well, you heard all of Marcus Malone's details and upcoming events here first. So, Marcus, tell us one more time about the Church Girls Rock event and where people can purchase tickets. And if they want to get in contact with you for bookings or for any other information, where can they go or how can they contact you?
Okay, Church Girls Rock is November the 7th at Oak Grove Baptist Church. That's on Highway 64, Memphis, Tennessee. Tickets are 10 advance, 15 at the door. You can find me on Facebook under Marcus Malone. I have two pages. One has maxed out, but don't get discouraged. Go to the next one. I'm playing a Hammond organ. So that's how you can find me. You can follow me on Instagram, Malone Boy. Also, Church Girls Rock has a page too, Church Girls Rock Memphis. All right, follow us on there. Visit our website, www.churchgirlsrockmemphis.com. And I think that's all the sites I'm on.
All right, well, next time you got to bring your keyboard and play for us. We have to have some kind of music going on if you're a musician.
I got
you. All right, but once again, this is L3 Television. I'm Erica Draper, and this was our wonderful guest, Marcus Malone.
Thanks for having me.
No problem. Thanks for coming.
L3 Media is the Mid-South's premier videography and photography company. We specialize in capturing all of life's greatest moments. Whenever you need talented and professional service for your special events or business, L3 Media is the company for you. You can contact us at all of our social media sites. You can like us on Facebook, check out our website, follow us on Twitter, or always feel free to email us. We are L3 Media, your number one source for all your videography and photography needs. Give us a call today.
Thank you for tuning in and watching L3 Television. For any great stories, email me directly at ericad@l3television.com. Also, check us out on Facebook at L3 Television and visit our website at www.l3television.com. And also, don't forget to be back with us next Wednesday at 10 p.m. and Sundays at 5 p.m. Once again, I'm Erica Draper. Thank you for watching.